What? Do you know the existence of the human elephant conflict? One thing is, elephants don't live in dense forests. Like, their habitats are somewhat similar to areas we use for chain cultivation in the dry zone. Because they won't shut, they don't go to these areas where they are thick forest. So, in those areas, more and more land is encroached or cleared for one thing, farming. General cultivation, second thing for settlements. And when unplanned development of this land is there, for example, when you don't consider the habitat or the range of an elephant or a herd of elephants, you go and build your house somewhere there in their habitat. So it's a matter of like who came first. Like it was originally their land that we have broken and encroached. You need to find different solutions for the requirement of houses or the requirement of areas in the country. So again then comes the problem of country being overpopulated. So for us to find solutions for the requirement of 22 million of people, we have to be more creative, more innovative. We should not clear or employ someone else's land to find resources for us. That's the basic thing. There are scientific research on how elephants use land and what are their habitats. So simply mitigate that. Simply avoid using those land. And what happens is in today's policy or the legal context, they don't use those scientific data. There are a few good scientists in terms of human elephant conflict, but policymakers refuse to use that knowledge in their policy making. The reason is simply they need to please those people in those areas. So they create more and more difficult problems for them in future. I'll take one example. I don't know whether you have heard about the deforestation happened above or the north of Vilpattu Forest Reserve. Right? There, it was said that those areas were cleared for human settlements. And there are the people who cleared those forests said it's for resettlement. There are minimum evidence that we can show it's not a resettlement, simply use maps for last 30-40 years where the forest cover was there. And the other thing is, by taking people there, you are creating more vulnerable communities because these people don't have basic facilities to live in those areas. They don't have water, they don't have a livelihood, some way of earning an income. And more than that, their lives are each passing day exposed to a lot of risks, lot of dangers. Because this is the country where there are elephants. One day elephant land, there are bears, there are other wildlife. Why should you take people and put it there? So these are very unplanned and very short term and stupid decisions. So this is, I brought you one example. This happens at many places in the country. Just don't think about the community, race or the religion. It happens everywhere in the country. environmental issues, like big issues in the country. Okay. It's numberless, like we can talk about days and days about these things, but certain things are, one thing, deforestation happens like nothing in this country. About 70 years back, we had a forest cover of 50%. Now, our primary forest, that is forest that is not touched or cleared, is 16%, but the government says with plantations and other things, is 29%. Plantations, you can't make fit natural forest in terms of services. I'll show you one picture. Yeah. Okay, this particular picture shows the forest cover in green patches. I don't know whether you could. Just if you want, just come forward and see. Forest cover in 1956, 1992 and 1999. If you draw the map in 2018, I think it will be more pathetic situation. We have been losing it at the rate of more 1%, and sometimes it could be more than 1% in certain years. So if we continue in another 10 years, it will be less than 50%. So that's why I want you also show, like when you talk about, when you teach people, use lot of maps. Actually, my maps are not the best. There are a lot of good ways of doing maps using Google Earth. Okay, so biodiversity. Biodiversity is not only animals, there are trees and different interactions among trees and animals and the other natural environment components like soil, that is biodiversity. Lot of environmental services you enjoy today are starting from good biodiversity. Biodiversity is not having one or two species in an area. It's having diversity. A lot of different species, and there is one concept, you have to have native species, we say. Because those are adapted species to that particular environment. They are only, we say, we need to maintain the balance. And with our intervention, if we deplete one, or if we let one species or one type of animals go extinct, then in the food chain, they are pretty.